So we're going to work, and then we're going to talk about working and talk about what we're working on. And through the magic of togetherness, we'll forge ahead for at least one more day. I'm wearing this hat. I know it's Halloween. I hope it's Halloween. But I'm wearing this hat because several years ago, Maria Goyans, who was a producer here, and I went to hear a wonderful nun come and children, brilliant mind. Yeah, and we heard her speak on Halloween, and she spoke in a witch's hat. And I just thought that was brilliant. So I'm just you know, in thinking of come and children today, I'm going to wear a witch's hat while I work. And I know, have you ever seen a witch typing on a red typewriter?
I haven't.
Oh, yes. Here's a picture of my line. This is great. They were giving me
really?
You stand in a little line and then they take your picture with your kid and it's just like, yippee, I know, yay, NYU. Thank you.
Wait, how did I miss that?
Well,
I'm not dressed as anything but a grad student.
Well, that's the way
that works.
Well, your son, you didn't hear your son.
He's 14 and his
shot. He might
go,
yeah, he's
too cool. He's old. Yeah, he's
face
old.
Painting and
I asked him, and he was like,
never too old for it.
Well, I always have a good time. But he's too cool for it.
He is. At this point.
That is a different thing.
And what are you, Drew? I mean, you're dressed as something. Look at you going, what are you dressed as? What is that?
I can say this because there's no children around. Yeah. The name of the character is Fucker Burke.
Oh, wow!
Love it.
Fucker Burke! Oh, like the grave digger?
From an Irish clockwork orange.
Oh, wow! An Irish clockwork orange.
You left your top hat upstairs.
Yeah, I love top hat too.
Well, Fucker Burke, I hope you get some action.
It seems that
way. You don't have any electrodes on you.
I hope you get some action. Right. Well, so we're going to work for 45 minutes, and then we're going to talk, and, are you Fucker Burke, or are you going to...
It's going to be fine until next week when we're on the camera.
Right. Fucker. Oh, we're allowed to say Fucker.
Hey,
we're all... Okay, here we go. All right. Yeehaw! Happy Halloween!
Yeah. works. Life is like that. So here we are, we did the work part, and we're going to do the dialogue part now. So, anybody have a question?
What?
Don't take me seriously in this hat? Just know. I know you know this already, but this hat is actually a true reflection of my nature. But I am a witch. Anybody have a question? No? Of a witch? Yes.
I always have a question.
Yes.
I actually have one commentary. Thank you for the last time.
Sure.
Because I've been able to just jump in.
See, you can never jump in.
And just do it. And that really helped my process a lot. Because the only way to do it is just write and then figure it out later.
So if I remember correctly, you had the screenplay assignment with the beats that you kind of have to get in.
Yeah.
It was like not very feeling very good.
Yeah, I think I had got accustomed to the way a play feels when I write it, and it didn't feel like that. So now in just writing it, it now has its own kind of feeling. I write it, so thank you for that. Yeah, I know. When you have your big gelatinous mountain of script, be it a screenplay or a play, a stage play, what's the first thing you do when you're going back to actually make it start?
Stacy.
I don't know.
The first thing that came to mind was these novels back in the day.
My last name is Rose, though, so that might make it easier. Rose like a flower. I tried.
I'll just have to remember. So Stacy asks, so you had your big gelatinous first draft, right? And now you wonder, what do you do, right? What are some steps for rewriting? Or some steps for rewriting, right? I would say that probably the most important thing is to make sure it's gelatinous, meaning let it cool. You know what I'm saying? Make sure it's gelatinous, like jello. Gelatinous? How do I spell it? I'm going to ask the wrong person. I'm a writer, not a speller. Shit. I'm a witch, I'm not a speller. I cast spells, I do not spell. Gelatinous. 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 I think that sounds very much like gelatinous. Say it again. Make sure it is actually gelatinous. That is, let it cool. COOL. So let it cool. Okay. I think Hemingway was good at this. If you put things like in a drawer, or if you have ever made a pie, you want to let it cool. Or if you've ever made jello, you want to let it chill. Okay. So let it do its thing with itself. Okay, which is great. It's the best part of writing, which is put in a drawer, preferably in an envelope. You know, keep it together. Maybe tie a ribbon around it.
It's literally the FedEx envelope
in my bag. Good, and you tie a little ribbon around it.
Okay.
You add that step. Because, why? When you go back to it, you open it, it's a present. I do that all the time. Oh, wow! You know, reframes experience, right? Okay, so you get in the garden and we talk about it. Anybody who's heard this before, I just know that they're consistent. When you write your draft, you're in the garden of anything grows and everything grows, right? Okay, now you want to switch and you want to take out your sword of discrimination. Not like, you know, the celebration, but you know what I'm talking about. What should be in and what should not be in. You know, know what is and know what ain't. Right? Okay? So you have to know what is and you have to know what ain't. And you go through your script cutting without mercy everything that you think that should be in you. Okay? And by letting it cool, having let it cool, you will see the holes. We're going to hear it much more effectively. Okay? The first thing is let it cool. You read it and you say, step on, let it cool. Like, I know, a week. Then you read it through aloud. Some people say in one sitting, which is good. Read it aloud in one sitting. Okay? And then go read it with a pen in hand. Just read it aloud.
Okay.
You know, then maybe after you're done reading, you scribble a few notes. Okay? Then you start thinking about it. Then you go back in and say, okay, it's 200 pages long. Let me look at 5 pages at a time. Or, if I need to rethink the whole thing, let me start kind of rethinking the whole thing. That's what I'm doing right now. Sometimes you don't dive right in, rewrite five pages a day. I just sit there and go, okay, wait a minute. I got the story right, but I'm, you know, it's just like the surface. I need to go to the next level, you know? Sometimes, you know, the first draft is your dry draft, your first period the whole time. And you want to shake it out. Where the story is actually working like this.
Yeah.
Instead of like, sometimes the first draft is just you just feel your will pulling it along, you know what I mean? You want to really get it so that the events are causing the events and the characters are actually working and all that kind of stuff. So you want to look out for that, and if it's cool, we'll have a chance. And sometimes you can do a lot of rewriting without actually getting in there, you know? Sometimes not just moving words around on the page. Sometimes actually just sitting back and rethinking, okay, this is the story, I did it, this is the story. A lot of times what I do is you write the whole draft, 200 pages, and then you write an outline based on that draft. So you can think about it in shorthand. So you're not following along with your sentences, you know? So you're just seeing the story at bare bones, and then you rewrite from that outline. So,
that's a lot of things to do.
I know, that's a lot of things. You only need one at a time.
No, it makes me feel like I have a direction to go.
Good. Just try that. Try the blend it cool and read it aloud. I'll see how you feel about it. Say the name of oil. Shoes. There were some shoes called Stacy Adams.
Of course. There it is.
Okay. Oh, soft. Yes, Lynn, how you doing?
How's it going? Well, you gave me an assignment last week, Jeff.
Yeah.
Catch up. 6 pages a day. And I froze.
Uh-huh.
So, and as long as you're moving in the direction of the end of the play. That is, you're not going back to rewrite, and then going forward, and then going back to rewrite, and then going, you're not doing this. You're not, this is a dance, but you're not doing this dance. You're doing this dance. Okay? Which is not as, you can do that. That's much better. But, you know, right?
Yeah, it's so funny because you mentioned that I remember, I mean, it's one of my favorite all kind of books.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's great, it's great. It's like lit.
Yeah, yeah,
great. But anyway, Peter Brooks did Not Love,
yes,
which I was honored enough to see.
Wow.
But I laughed because maybe he was more of a Mahabharata, which is a great never story.
Invited to do something in a short little, a theater company's short little festival evening.
Right.
This past Tuesday, I submitted my work. They asked me for actors, and they say, you know, they don't identify as any particular ethnicity, but they embrace diversity. And so I recommended actors of color, pretty much, for this. And I really didn't have anything to do with it. I went to see the show, and my show was the only one with any actors of color in it. I mean, there were about seven other shows. There was no other show that had, none of the other shows had a reason. They were generic characters, as we say. And me and the actress that I'd recommended had a little moment, you know, an intermission, saying like, hey. And I realized she was very uncomfortable. And I was very uncomfortable. Just because of the makeup and because what had been set out.
Yeah.
So I don't know how to approach this company or if I should approach this company regarding this kind of issue. And I don't know if it's, you know, as a playwright who was invited, do I just not then, if it's not a theater company that declares an ethnicity?
You're about to.
Uh-huh.
You know, you choose your battles, and when you choose your battle, it feels like an engagement, where you want to engage. And I would say engage where it really matters to you. You have something at stake, you know, you really love this company, you really want them to succeed, you've been invited to their, board or inner circle or their whatever, they're asking for your opinion, they're looking to you. In terms of your own plays, what I do is I can do sew it into the lining of the play. You know, I've done things like Hester Valdivinta. Now, the play does not turn on the fact that Hester in the blood is black.
Thanks for coming. Happy Halloween.